ప్రైజ్ ద లార్డ్, హల్లెలూయా. థ్యాంక్ యూ జీసస్, థ్యాంక్ యూ హోలీ స్పిరిట్, థ్యాంక్ యూ అబ్బా ఫాదర్. వేర్ షాల్ వి ఫైండ్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ టు వర్షిప్ అవర్ గాడ్? కెన్ ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ టు జాయిన్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్స్ ప్లీజ్? వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్రే. లార్డ్, యూ ఆర్ ద పోటర్, ఐఎమ్ ద క్లే, ఐఎమ్ స్టాండింగ్ బిఫోర్ యూ లార్డ్. బ్లెస్ మీ లార్డ్, ఐ జస్ట్ బి విత్ యూ జీసస్. ఐ నీడ్ యువర్ అనాయింటింగ్. Joining the hands, we pray, we sing, and we worship. When you repeat a single word of God, the anointing of that word of God will reach your family. Hallelujah. So lift your right hand and repeat this word of God after me, and claim this word of God after me. God will touch you. Isaiah 59:1. Repeat this word of God. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened, that it cannot save, or his ear dull,
dull.
That it cannot hear.
That it cannot hear.
Pray with me. Oh Jesus.
Oh Jesus.
I surrender.
I surrender.
My pains.
My pain.
My agony.
My agony.
My worries.
My worries.
Unto you.
Unto you.
By the power of this word of God.
By this power of the word of God.
I am blessed.
I am blessed.
I am delivered.
I am delivered.
Hallelujah.
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 Everyone, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lift your right hand and once again say another word of God. I am the Lord.
I am the Lord.
Your God.
Your God.
From the land of Egypt.
From the land of Egypt.
You know.
No God. No God.
But me.
But me.
And besides me.
And besides me.
There is no Savior.
There is no Savior.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Jesus.
I surrender.
I surrender.
My family.
My family.
Unto you.
Unto you.
There is no other God.
There is no other
rather
God.
Rather than you.
Rather than you.
You are my God.
You are my God.
You are the potter.
You are the potter.
Mold me.
Mold me.
Bless me.
Bless me.
Anoint me.
Anoint me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Repeat this word of God after me. Surrender your family and pray with me. Book of Psalms chapter 46 verses 10. Be still.
Be still.
And know that.
And know that.
I am God.
I am God.
Everyone, be still.
Be still.
And know.
And know
that I am God.
That I am God.
Hallelujah.
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 Everyone singing together. You are the potter. I am the clay. Mold me and make me. Mold my family, Lord. Joining the hands, we sing together.
You are the
Hallelujah. Let us worship our God, everyone together. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory to you, Lord, glory to you, glory to you, glory to you. All glory to you, all glory to you, all glory to you, all glory to you. Hallelujah, 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 Father, hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Close your eyes, please surrender everyone in the family by name unto the Holy Cross. Jesus is telling you, I am the Lord your God from the land of Egypt. You know no God but me, and besides me there is no Savior. He is your Savior. He is your Deliverer. And only He is our Savior. If you confess with your lips that He is your Savior, today salvation has come. Amen. I bind every evil spirit in the name of Jesus.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. And blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today now we are going to listen the message of our His Grace Archbishop Thomas McCowan, Archbishop of Gandhinagar Archdiocese. We are so happy to listen to him. This message is exclusively for the viewers, for those who are attending this holy adoration, holy hour of Eucharistic media. God bless you. Just believe that your faith will result joy in the family. Believe that your faith will result joy in your family. Say it in your heart. Your faith will result joy in your family. Hallelujah. Let's listen to the message of our Archbishop, His Grace Thomas McCowan. God bless you. Amen.
I'd like to begin this talk from the Bible, especially taking the Gospel of St. Mark, chapter 3, verses 31 and the following. Then his mother and his brothers came, and standing outside, they sent to him and called him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they said to him, Your mother and your brother and sisters are outside asking for you. And he replied, Who are my mother and my brothers? And looking at those who sat around him, he said, Here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother. The Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, what is very important for us in life? The most important thing for us is to be people of faith. God gave us this wonderful gift at the time when we were conceived in our mother's womb. He gave us faith, He gave us hope, and He gave us charity. Wonderful gifts. And faith is a foundational gift. Through faith we can trust in God. I'd like to share with you the great personalities of our Holy Bible. In the Old Testament, I really appreciate Abraham, our father in faith. Wonderful example for all of us. Abraham was happily living in his hometown. There was all security because his family, his kins, his near ones and dear ones were all with him. And suddenly he gets the call. He gets the call from within. Probably he heard something, but the call was to leave all that and to go to the place where God would take him. He did not know where he would be going. He only knew that I have to go, and he prepared his way to go, and he reached the place where the Heavenly Father wanted him to go. There was a lot of difficulties to travel. He had to give up his family. He had to face problems for security. He would be attacked at any time. But he goes. While on the journey, he had Lot with him. And there was a quarrel between the shepherds of Lot and the shepherds of Abraham, especially for the grazing of grounds where their sheep could go and graze, because there was not sufficient for both the sheep of both of Abraham and of Lot. And so look at the way Abraham settled this whole issue. He tells Lot, "Lot, you look and you see which side you would like to go. If you go to the north, I'll go to the south. If you go to the east, I'll go to the west. You decide." Giving Lot the full freedom to decide, and Lot looks for the wonderful land where there were plenty of trees, plenty of pastoral grounds, plenty of water to feed his sheep, and he chose that, whereas Abraham chose desert and mountains. He went in the opposite direction, but that became the center of the world because Christ was born there. Our Savior was born there. Again, when Abraham, well, he was promised that he would be having a son, it took 25 years to fulfill that promise, but he trusted in God. And when he was almost 100 years old, his wife gave birth to Isaac. The promise was fulfilled. He trusted in God. And the test came into his life. When God asked him, "Take your son and get him sacrificed," a tremendous test. Did he love God or did he not love God? Did he have faith in the word of God? He gave priority to God's word, and he took his son. And when he was about to sacrifice him, he was stopped from doing that act. God saved his son. And there God provided him the sheep that was needed to be sacrificed. God provides. That place is called God provides because God always provides for the person who trusts in him. That is our father in faith, who was always trusting in God, doing the will of the Father. Very difficult to accept that, to leave his plan, his place, to be ready to sacrifice his son, but he did not turn back, he went ahead. In the New Testament, we have our Heavenly Mother Mary, a young girl already betrothed to Joseph, and she was approached by Angel Gabriel, and we know all that happened. At the end of it, she said, "I am the handmaid of the Lord, let it be done to me according to God's desire, according to God's will." And this is the call. She responded very well. She accepted everything that happened in her life because she said yes. She was very happy to give birth to Jesus, but then she had to run away to Egypt for a couple of years. Who would like to go from one's own place and dwelling? But she went with Joseph. And when they came back again, there was only poverty. Nothing good comes from Nazareth. Only poverty, no money, no richness, no facilities. But she accepted all that God told her. And she stood under the cross, seeing her own son. All the promises that were made to her at the time of the Annunciation, seemed to have finished. But then we know God rose from the dead. Jesus rose from the dead. Yes, she fulfilled God's will totally. What did God do for both of them? Abraham became our father in faith because he did only the will of the Father. Mother Mary was taken up to heaven, body and soul, and she is there with the Heavenly Father, with the Holy Spirit, with Jesus, our Son, very close to them. Gave such a wonderful place there in heaven because she did the will of the Father. And Jesus was raised from the dead because he did the will of the Father. He's the best example for us. He says, my food is to do the will of the Father. I have come only to do what the Father wants me to do. In the Garden of Gethsemane, he says 3 times, if possible, take away this cup, but let your will be done. That was the call. Let your will be done. Yes, he fully accepts the cross. He dies on the cross. God raised him from the dead. And there he's seated at the right hand of the Father. And on the last day of the judgment, he'll come back with the Father in all glory to judge the living and the dead. God raises up. If we want to be great before God, we have to do the will of the Father. And that is what Jesus says in today's gospel, which I read before you. He says, whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother. The will of God. We want to do our will. We want to satisfy our things. But God wants that we do his will. And that is why every moment should be lived doing the will of the Father. We take a pencil and we make a dot on a piece of paper. Next to that dot, we put another dot, and hundreds of dots. It will become a straight line. Therefore, we won't find dots over there. We'll find a straight line. That is called a contour. And this is what we are asked to do. Every moment in our lives, we have to keep on doing God's will. Anything happens, good, your will be done. If difficult moments come, your will be done. If we are very busy with some work and somebody comes to meet us, Father, your will be done. If we are talking with someone and some important phone call comes, your will be done. Anything we do, we have to allow God's will to be done in our lives. And when we allow God's will to be done in our lives, he will glorify us. How do we do the will of the Father? How do we please the Father? Jesus says, if you love me, you will follow my commandments. You will carry out my commandments. And so, loving God, doing his will, is to do and follow his commandments right from the bottom of our heart, from our being. But let us pray to God that he may give us plentiful of blessings and graces, that our faith may be strong and that we may do only his will and only God's will. Thank you.
Eternal Father, we offer you the body and blood, the soul and divinity of your only beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the atonement of our sins and the sins of the whole world. Lifting the right hand and surrendering the family, for the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole
world. Holy Lord, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Holy Lord, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Holy Lord, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Everyone repeat this prayer after me. This is going to be a very, very powerful prayer if you trust in the power of God. Jesus said, if you have the faith of a mustard seed, If you tell this mountains to be uprooted and fall into the sea, it will obey you. If you have the faith, many people, many things, many systems will obey you. Just pray with faith. Along with me, looking at Jesus, say this prayer. Oh my Jesus, I trust in you.
Oh my Holy Spirit,
I trust in you.
Oh Abba Father,
I trust in you.
Every pain,
every worries,
every tension,
every agony,
I surrender to you
with my faith.
Hallelujah.
Oh my Lord.
Wash me.
With your precious blood.
Hallelujah.
I bind.
Every evil spirit.
In the name of Jesus.
I command you.
O evil spirit.
To leave me.
To leave my family.
Today.
Right now.
By the power of the word of God.
Hallelujah. I have the authority.
To cast you out.
Hallelujah.
I belong to Jesus.
My family
belongs to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We are
purchased
by the blood of God.
Hallelujah.
Saint Michael, pray for us. Saint Gabriel, the Archangel, pray for us. Saint Raphael, the Archangel, pray for us. We say one Hail Mary together. Hail Mary,
full of grace.
The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. And blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hallelujah.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, listen very carefully. We find God saved three people from the well. One is named Joseph in the Old Testament. His own brothers put him into the well in the desert. You know, the well in the desert is very dangerous. There can be poisonous snakes, very sharp objects, stones. Once you fall down, you cannot expect a life back. But the one who put him into the well, the same person, the same people took him back out of the well. The second person that you find in the Old Testament is Jeremiah. Some people out of jealousy put Jeremiah into the well, and it was full of mud, and he was about to die, but the intervention of God came there, and the people, they put him into the well. The same people lifted him up. Hallelujah. Believe that power of God. And the third person that we find is Prophet Daniel. King ordered to put Daniel into the den of lions. It's a well. And the same king who ordered to put him into the den of lions ordered to take him back. God will lift you up from any kinds of well. Believe that if you have the faith. No one can lift you from the well. No one can help you or save you from the clutches of some enemies. Only God. Believe in it. Today we heard the message of our Archbishop that the power of faith will result joy in our heart. Believe that way. This is the time that we have to surrender and pray. Can I lift all of you to lift your right hand? Can I request you to lift your hands, please? Close your eyes. Surrender your family unto God. And we all worship our God. Wherever you are, God will lift you. Believe that and just pray. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh Jesus, we adore you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Worship you, adore you, adore you, adore you, adore you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We pray for all the people asked our prayers, especially we pray for during this so many people asked our prayers through emails and WhatsApp messages. We pray for Vincent, we pray for Daryl, we pray for Alan, we pray for Daisy, we pray for Joseph, we pray for Maria, we pray for Walsa, we pray for Lawrence, we pray for all the people affected by coronavirus, we pray for the broken families. All those families are here around this holy altar right now. All the people requested our prayers are around our altar. We surrender them. You are the porter, Lord. You are the one who is lifting us, Lord. We surrender and pray by faith. This adoration will bring joy and changes in our lives. You are the potter. I am the clay. Mold me and make me to be a new creation. God is blessing you.
You change my